Hello everyone, this is Ahmed Dawn of AhmedDawn.com. On this channel, you'll find financial, travel and more videos just like the one you're watching right now. If you like what you see, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Hello everyone, this is Ahmed Dawn of AhmedDawn.com. On this channel, you'll find financial, travel and more videos just like the one you're watching right now. If you like what you see, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Today, I'll be unboxing and do a brief review of the RBC British Airways Visa Infinite card, which is right here. And before I do that, I'd like to talk about the British Airways Executive Club or Avios points, because this card is all about Avios points, which are also the same as the British Airways Executive Club points, which is right here. Now, the sole purpose of this freight card should be to collect Avios points, and in order to do that, if you'd like to collect Avios points, then you should know in and out, and you should know all the basics of the One World and how the airlines alliance work and how the Avios points work. Now, the One World alliance is made of these airlines, for example, Air Berlin, American Airlines, British Airways. Let me just zoom a little bit here. And Cathay Pacific, Finnair, Qatar Airways, Japan Airlines, Qantas, Malaysia, Sri Lankan, all these airlines. I believe there are 16 airlines, but I'll just make sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yeah, there are 16 airlines altogether. So when you have Avios points, you'll be able to use on any of these member airlines. You don't have to use on British Airways. And actually, you shouldn't be use Avios on British Airways, because British Airways implements heavy fuel surcharges on Avios points. So if you redeem them on British Airways, then you'll be paying heavy fuel surcharges, which you can easily avoid on other airlines. And also, British Airways is getting worse day by day. Earlier this year, they eliminated free food and drinks on their short-haul flights, and they're actually considering eliminating free food and drinks on long-haul flights. Of course, this is in the economy class. And in terms of the way they treat their own executive club members, which are the holders of Avios points, they make them or force them to pay heavy charges, which you can easily avoid with other airlines. So anytime you're having a credit card which are tied to any airline program, you need to know all about that airline program to successfully redeem your points. Now, in Canada, only a few credit cards are attached to airline points. For example, we have here the British Airways Avios Visa Infinite, which of course with tied to British Airways Avios points and One World Alliance. And then we have from RBC WestJet Master credit card, which is also tied to WestJet Airlines. And actually, recently WestJet announced that you can use WestJet points to redeem for Delta Airlines. And then we have the TD Aeroplan Visa Infinite card, which is tied to the Aeroplan program, which is a part of the another airlines alliance. And then we have another credit card, which is the MBNA Alaska Airlines card, which is tied to Alaska Mileage Plan. And the beauty of Alaska Mileage Plan is that it's not tied to any airlines. Rather, it sort out, it pick specific members from all alliances and non-alliances. So when you have Alaska mileage plan points, then you can actually redeem for many airlines without, it's not tied to any alliances. So I cannot think of any other credit cards in Canada that give you points for airlines except these four card right now. So again, whenever you have a credit card which is attached to any alliance, then you should be knowing everything about that alliance or in the program, so you can redeem it for to maximize your points. So now the British Airways Avios program is tied to One World, and then you can easily fly for any other any members of that program, and you should avoid British Airways because they charge hefty fuel surcharges. Now, the British Airways credit card I have here. Before I open the credit card, I would like to mention that this is very similar to RBC's another credit card, which is the Visa Infinite Avion credit card, which I have it right here. Now, the point earning ratio or rate is very similar between these two cards. If you take a look at here, that you can take you get 1 point per dollar spent on this card, and then on the British Airways card, your earning rate is same, 1 point per one Avios per each dollar spent. However, they're saying that you receive a companion hour e-voucher. So what it means that once you have enough point to redeem for British Airways, then they would give you a points. They would give you a companion flight for free. Now, in order to do that, you have to spend $30,000 per year, and then you have to redeem the flight on Avios points. And then the same problem here, whenever you're redeeming Avios for British Airways, you're gonna be hit with hefty fuel surcharges. So receiving a companion flight each year after spending $30,000 just to pay hefty fuel surcharges, which can be easily avoided with flying other alliance members here, makes no sense. So you shouldn't be having this card to get the companion fare, because you will spend much on fuel surcharges and you lose money. And another advantage it has, that it gives you 10% discount on British Airways flights when you purchase using this card, the RBC British Airways. And that, again, you want to avoid flying British Airways. And the other thing about this card I don't like, although you're paying more, for example, your annual fee is here $165 per year, and for this Avion card is only $120 per year. So although your annual fee is $165, you're not getting full insurance coverage. For example, it doesn't have trip cancellation insurance, it doesn't have trip interruption insurance, which are the most vital insurances for travel insurance. It has some insurances, for example, it has purchase security and extended warranty, medical insurance, flight delay insurance, hotel, motel, burglary insurance, auto rental, collision and damage, travel accident. However, it doesn't have trip cancellation and trip interruption insurance. So in terms of insurance, the British Airways card is a weak card. So you shouldn't have this card to book when you purchase your travel tickets, for example, hotel or plane, because you're losing some insurances. And another thing with this British Airways card is that you get flat 1 point per dollar spent. And with Visa Infinite Avion, you're getting 1 point per dollar spent as well. However, from time to time, RBC runs promotion where you can transfer points at 150% or 125% bonus. For example, if you have 10,000 points, you'd be getting 15,000 points when you transfer to Avios. So that's the beauty of this card, that although you're essentially, you're earning only 1 point per dollar, however, when you transfer and you wait for the RBC promotion, then you can convert your points from 1:1.5 or 1.25. So this is a better card in terms of earning and in terms of insurance, in terms of annual fee and everything. So this card, British Airways, I wouldn't make it a regular day-to-day card. The reason I got this card, because they're offering 30,000 bonus points. I'm sorry, 50,000 bonus points if you spend $9,000 in the first 3 months. So in the end, 35 plus 15, I'll be getting 50,000 Avios bonus points after I spend $9,000 in 3 months. And that's the purpose of my having this card. And then after that, once I'm close to 1 year, I'm going to cancel this card because I wouldn't want to pay $165 another year for a card which doesn't have full insurance coverage and which doesn't give you any bonus point transfer and which doesn't give you any other benefits. So there's no point to keep this card year after year. Now, the British Airways Visa Infinite card has Visa Infinite Concierge because it's a Visa Infinite card, so that's a good thing. You can call 24/7 for any type of help, travel, booking, any questions, any problem, you're in a foreign land. So because any card part of Visa Infinite would provide you that service. And this card actually has the same service because it's a Visa Infinite card as well right here. So that's all about points for now. Now let's go to unboxing our card. Okay, so I'll just put this aside a little away. Actually, just to make it better, let me fold this here. Okay, so here. Okay, so there's nothing inside the envelope. I'll put it aside for now. And looks like we have a brochure type of thing which says British Airways here, and then I'll put it aside for now, and we have a credit card in here. So the credit card in this letter, I'll just set it aside for now, and let's go through the brochure. Okay, so it has a nice cover and looks like we have some disclosure here. So let's take a look at these. Okay, so this is just talks about your initial credit limit, annual interest rate, interest-free grace period, determination of interest, all sort of stuff. And minimum payment, foreign currency conversion. Most Canadian cards charges 2.5% foreign currency when you make purchases in other currency than Canadian dollars. However, there are some cards that do not charge that, and I have discussed those cards on my YouTube channel, which you can view later on. So here they have annual fee, other fees, promotional rate. So this is just some information about the card. I'll set it aside for now. And then here we have RBC credit card agreement. Oh, this is looks like a long page, and this just, you know, spells out everything about your card and making payments and some here. We have a chart showing other RBC cards, annual fees and other information. And so this is just some information on crate person stuff, and same here on the back. So whenever you have a crate car, you should actually go through these briefly, because there are lots of information. People have crate cars and they do not know, and then they realize later on when they do a mistake. Okay, so I'll set it aside for now. Now let's open up this one brochure here. So this is benefit guides, RBC Visa Infinite Avion card, Visa Infinite British Airways card, and we have British Airways Avios points logo here. And let's take a look here. So let your expectations soar. So here just tells about how much you're getting. For example, 1 point per dollar and 2 points per dollar when you spend on British Airways. And then insurance tells about the insurances, but we already know that it doesn't have trip cancellation and trip interruption. An additional benefit, complimentary 24/7 concierge service, which is actually provided by Visa Infinite, not RBC. And then exclusive access to Kiwi collection, music and dining privileges. So all these are actually provided by Visa Infinite. And then you have to activate your card, which we understand. And then there's just a picture here. Okay, now it's here is just showing you that you can earn faster by purchasing every day with this card, which we understand that. And here, as a member of the British Airways Executive Club, every Avios you earn will be automatically credited to your account, and you will also receive priority waitlist, meal preferences, executive offers, ability to access. Okay, reward flights for travel on British Airways and on any one world airline with your Avios, which I just described a little bit before that. Once you have a member of a airline point program, then you can redeem your points for any airline, any members of that alliance. For example, for this one, British Airways, we counted that there are 16 alliances. If you have Aeroplan, then there are, which is a part of the Star Alliance, and which are, I believe there are more than 23 or 25 members. So it's just like that what they're describing here. And then here, takeoff sooner. So it's just, you know, there's they're giving you a breakdown, a little bit information about how many Avios points you need to fly. For example, London, you require 50,000 Avios points. And Italy 65, India 100,000, and spend 30,000 more and you'll be getting a companion award voucher, which you can use to bring along a companion, same flight, same class, same cabin, the next time you book your reward flights with British Airways. That's the catch. That's what they're trying to get you, the card, and keep it year after year to spend 30,000. And you redeem on Avios on British Airways, and then you get a companion voucher. But it's not a good idea, as I mentioned before, they impose heavy fuel surcharges. And another quick note about Avios program, that most other rewards program are actually chart based or zone based. They have their, you know, points required to redeem would be based on zone. For example, for Asia, Europe would be another zone, Africa. However, Avios doesn't work that way. It's a distance based program. It doesn't based on any zone, it's based on distance. So if you have long flights, usually it's not a good idea to long distance, it's not a good idea to redeem Avios. But if you have short distance, then you can make good redemption on Avios. For example, before Avios had $4,500 points redemption within North America, but they stopped it. I believe it's now 7,500 points once they devalued the Avios program. Okay, so now Visa Infinite advantages, zero card holder liability, travel made special, which they're just talking about the concierge looking after you in the air and on the ground. I mentioned that, you know, you can call to your concierge anytime and they'll give you, they will help you anyway. However, there are other credit cards they provide concierge services to. They may not be Visa Infinite Concierge, but they are different concierges. For example, American Express Platinum has concierge, BMO World Elite MasterCard has concierge. So there are lots of other concierge services. And then here, just talking about adding a pre-authorized payment and stuff. And here, looks like they're giving us some telephone numbers to call. For example, Visa Infinite concierge phone number. So for example, actually these Visa Infinite web address and concierge phone number would work for any credit card which has Visa Infinite logo on it. So let's say you don't have to wait for RBC Visa Infinite card to call Visa Infinite concierge and get help. If you have a TD card or CIBC Infinite card, Visa Infinite card, this is the same number and website, they will provide you help. Okay, so we went through this. I'll put it back here. And then looks like we have a insurance of certificate here. So it just, you know, gives you details of all the insurances this card has. And we'll not go through all these. And we already know that this card doesn't provide you vital insurances you would require when you travel, which are trip cancellation and trip interruption insurance. And then we have a notice regarding upcoming annual changes. So this is just about they're changing the annual fee and stuff. They always increase the annual fee and other fees. So whenever you have a credit card, do not keep or carry over balances from month to month. Always pay on time, and that way you can enjoy all the benefits, all the points, and you don't have to pay interest, any interest fee. Okay, so here we are done with that. I'll just set it aside for here. And then let's go back to our card. Okay, so here is just a letter mentioning that, okay, here's your new card. And set up your pre-authorized payment and all sort of stuff. And on this side of the page, we have the credit limit, the annual fee, determination of interest, minimum payment, foreign currency, all sorts of information. Okay, so let's take out the card. Okay, so here we have the card, and I'll just take off this sticker and then I'll show you. Okay, just put it here for now. Okay, so this is how it looks like. It's a black card. It has British Airways logo right here, RBC logo right here, and Visa Infinite logo right here. And actually they had my Avios number right here, which I like, because my TD Visa Infinite credit card doesn't have the airplane number on the card, but looks like they, for this one, they put the British Airways executive member plan number or Avios number right here. Okay, so this is how the British Airways Visa Infinite card looks like. And again, this card has $165 annual fee, and you earn 1 point per dollar spent. However, in terms of making it a long term, I wouldn't suggest to make this a long term, because you get better deal on this card, which is Visa Infinite Avion, because Avion has better insurance coverages, and Avion has more option because it gives you promotional transfer throughout the year. So you will be able to get more points when you transfer to same Avios from Avion. However, with British Airways, when you earn the Avios directly with this card, there is no such promotion. So you are in advantage with this card than this card. However, the reason getting this card is that from time to time they're on promotion. For example, they're giving 50,000 points or Avios points when you spend certain amount of money. This time it is $9,000, so that's the reason for my card. But except that, I believe this card is a better option than this card, because it gives you more choices and more insurance coverages. Okay, so that's all for now, and I do have other credit card unboxing and reviews on my YouTube channel, and I'll be writing them about on ahmeddawn.com as well. If you have been following me, then you know that I'm moving my airline journal website to ahmeddawn.com. So I'll be moving for the new post, I'll be putting them on ahmeddawn.com. And also keep an eye on my channel for other travel points programs and travel tips. Thank you for watching. If you like what you see, please consider subscribing and give it a thumbs up. Thank you.